Hello dear student of class 8, welcomes on D.V. Moyle Public Schools e-learning class. I am your social science teacher, Manish Sabde. Dear student, we are going to learn the marginalization and constitutional provisions. Here, see this picture. The victims of backwardness comprise the present scheduled caste SC, scheduled tribes ST, other backward classes OBC, and many minority groups. Also suffered from backwardness. These are the marginalized groups in India. Dear student, these are the marginalized groups in India. So, here the simple definitions of marginalization. Marginalization means the social process of discriminating and isolating an individual or a group to a lower or an outer age and treating them as inferiors. In most cases, the deprivation leads to impoverishment and unemployment. It is the marginalization. Here we know it is banned by the Indian Constitution. The discriminations on the basis of religion, race, class, place of birth and creed. So dear student, let us now study some constitutional provision which safeguard the marginalized sections of our society. Here, some constitutional provision. We have fundamental rights, right to equality, protective discriminations, untouchability, right against exploitation, special provisions for minorities, and directive principles of state policy. In fundamental rights, right to equality. Our constitution lays down that there will be a social equality and no person in our country discriminated on the basis of caste, religion, creed, and place of birth. The state can make the special provision like protective discrimination. In protective discrimination, here the protective discrimination comes under Article 15. It means that the state can make the special provisions to protect the interest of socially, economically backward classes. The government can implement social or special schemes and measures so then that they can get opportunity to occupy better socio-economic positions. It is all about protective discrimination. Stop untouchability. It comes under Article 17 in our Indian Constitution. We know untouchability is an inhuman product of caste system. It is an antisocial practice of touching a person of a certain caste. But in reality, it is a form of social isolation of certain caste and communities. It was in the past. Dalit face certain prohibitions from the dominant caste. Here the right against exploitation. Dear student, the Constitution provides for abolition of trafficking in human beings, beggars, or forced laborers. Ban on the employment of children below the age of 14 years in dangerous jobs like mines and factories. Also, government has the special provisions for minorities. The fundamental rights like the right to freedom of the religion and culture and educational rights have special provisions for the minorities to protect their distinct culture and safeguard it from the influence of majority. Dear student, the fundamental duties comes into under Article 51A. The Constitution safeguard the interest of the minorities. Directive principles of the state policy. We know the directive principles of the state policy are not enforceable by law, but they do lay down the important fundamentals in the governance of the country. They direct the states to apply these principles while making laws to secure a social order for the promotion of the welfare of the people. The directive principles aim to minimize the inequalities in income and eliminate the inequalities of the status, along with providing facilities and opportunities. The directive principles ensure that the material resources of the country are utilized for the common good. So, dear students, these are the constitutional provisions for safeguard the marginalized sections of society. In this topic, we learn about the constitutional provisions, fundamental rights, right to equality, protect to discrimination, untouchability, right against exploitations, special provisions for minorities, and directive principles of state policy. Here, dear student, I hope you understand today's topic. So, one assignment questions on it, on today's topic. Dear student, I hope you understand today's topic. We will meet in next period with next topic. Thank you for watching this video.